A lot of people called it prison when I was growing up. But these are my roots and this is what I love. 'Cause everybody knows me and I know them, and I believe that's the way we were supposed to live. I wouldn't trade one single day here in small town U.S.
What's up, everybody? It's old Jimbo.
Possum.
Team Country Boys Outdoors. We're sitting here at Bolins Fishing Lake tonight, Wednesday, June the 15th, 2016. Hope all y'all doing well out there, all our subscribers. Been real busy, ain't been to the fishing lake none, ain't made no videos. But we here tonight, gonna fish a little bit then. And boy, I tell you what, now it's hot. I love Moses, it's hot. I'm a sweating something fierce. But we've been fishing about 15 minutes, I reckon. Just getting started, really. And you can't really see nothing, our flags or nothing, because we're sitting so far back on the counter right here, shade, and you can see up yonder where the shade line's at. We tucked way up in here behind this truck. But wanted to say thank you to all our subscribers. The last time I checked, looked like we was right at 200. And boy, I tell you, that just tickles us to death. But we had a couple requests and some questions over the past couple of weeks, and we're going to try to address them tonight. I thank Trevor. Trevor, you out there wanting to know about showing us how we pack our bait and all that. We're going to do that tonight, and hopefully that we can get some action on camera and get some filming done here with some live action tonight. But it's Jimbo and Possum. 12 even was just caught, first fish of the night, paying on every 30 minutes here. But Jimbo and Possum, and we'll get back to you here directly, and hope to have some action for you. All right, everybody, Jimbo and Possum, my Team Country Boys Outdoors. About 7:15, we're standing here fishing, and hadn't had much action yet, just a little bit of bumping and pecking. But been slow around the lake. But they're starting to pick up, seeing more people catch some fish. So hopefully we'll see some action here soon. And just as I say that, this one right here that I'm showing you, he just kind of bumped it a little bit. The flag's laying in the water. But we are fishing. Six hole. Let me get out of the way. They're starting to bite now. Possum just got a bite on his middle one there. But we at it, and we'll try to come to you. Just wanted to check in with you. Got one, like always, in close right here. Love to see him rip out of here with it. But we'll come back to you on a bait packing tutorial, so to speak, in and get old Trevor there. His question asked and answered, rather, and we'll do that for you. We don't let it play here a minute, just see what happens.
All right, Trevor, we're going to answer your question, how to pack our bait.
All right, Trevor, it's the simple way I do it. Nothing special about it. I take my pops, puffs, kicks, whatever you're using. This is a flavored pop. I'm going to take this one and another flavored pop. And I'm just going to thread it through the hook, and I usually try to go to the shank there.
We got to run, folks. We got to run. All right, we gotta run. We got. Oh. All right, folks. Jimbo's gotta run. I need.
Here, find your fish. Find your fish.
How's it feel, Jimbo?
Feels pretty good right now.
All right. Well, that might be a good one. They're not head. Get him, Daddy. Get him. Get him, Jimbo. That's a 20 pounder. That's a 20. That's a 20.
I think it's 20.
Huh?
I don't think he's 20.
Jimbo, can I get the hooks out?
Sorry about that, Trevor. But we will get it. Let's get these hooks out of him. We'll take him to the scales.
All right, Trevor, back to what we was talking about, how to bait our hooks.
Sorry about that, Trevor, but when a fish calls, you got to answer, if you know what I mean. But
yeah.
He didn't weigh nothing but 12 pounds. He was old 12-pounder that thought he was a 40-pounder. He is this mean. This is where I put my pops, or puffs in this case. This go right past the bend on the shank yonder. And I just dampen my hands just a little bit if I got something sticky. On this case, I'm going to be putting on some grits. This is the Hulk grits. And I just lay my hook in the middle of the bait pile. And then I just close my hand over and push like that kind of motion. And since this one's going off the bank, I'm only going to give it about 5 or 6 compressions and just roll it like that. Leave one hook exposed. And that's how I do it. Now, if I was to throw this out a little bit further, I'd probably give it about 5 or 6 more compressions and to let it fly. That's how we do it right there. Hope this helps you out, Trevor. Hope that answers your question. Thanks again, guys. Hope we'll come back at you something else here later.
Top line, stay everybody, wet nets.
All right, y'all, this is Possum's fish. We couldn't get it on camera. Chandler, get your carp caddy here, son. We're gonna load him up. Pretty good fish. Old Possum stuck him. Take him to the scales, bud. I'll get you in the water. All right, everybody, Jimbo and Old Possum here, Team Country Boys Outdoors, coming back at you. Old Possum done stuck his hand in front of the camera yonder. We apologize for them last couple videos, are kind of rough, but it was trying to bait a hook yonder, and that one took off, and then Chandler, Old Possum, he went to the bathroom when that big one yonder lit out with it, but he weighed 18.2, so we won't apologize, though, for the quality. You'll liable have to flip your camera or your screen a little bit there and watch that one. But that's a nice fish, and come off that hook bait yonder, which you'll not find. But we still are fishing, and we staying at it, and we're going to keep trying to catch them here. We took that spot, and we holding the first $5 side pot right now, but there's lots of fishing left to go to 11 o'clock in, and it's, I don't know, probably 8:35, 8:40. Only takes 1 second at a carp lake. We're going to stay at it, and we'll come back at you. We'll let this play just a minute, see if we can't luck up and get something to happen here while we're holding it, and then we'll come back at you directly.
Everybody, that one that we was talking about ran out of nowhere, and he's working on it right now. Not head. I can name him Jimbo.
A little old knot head on this one, but it's a fish. Same down right there, bud. Hey, Jimbo and Possum, Team Country Boys Outdoors. Another one on. All right, y'all. It's Team Country Boys Outdoors at Jimbo and Possum. We still at it. That big old hog just rolled right yonder. You can see the wake in the water then. About down to 12% on my phone battery, so we're going to have to throw her in the truck and put her on charge right quick in and see if we can be able to close something out or even see if we can catch something on video, have enough battery to catch it on film before we leave here. Hopefully we can get another good run. We still after it. It's about 20 after 9, I expect. I want to say again, thanks to everybody for all you subscribers, all your thumbs up, all your comments, your questions. I'll have to scroll through there tonight or tomorrow because I think there was another question from Trevor. Trevor, if you did ask another question, I'll have to find it and so I can get back to you, but I ain't forgot you. I just got to find it. I got here and didn't have much Wi-Fi at first down there near the shack yonder. And I clicked on the question in my notifications, but it never would load, so I'm not real sure where it's at. But I will find it, and I will get you a reply. Tell you, it's been slow on us tonight. Mm-hmm. But you can't complain when you catch a good fish like we caught. But we, like I told you, about 3 weeks ago when I come here and I was fishing this same hole. This is a tough lake and I don't think I've quite got it figured out yet. But I think I'm close. And I'll just keep at it and keep working it and until I can get it figured out. Like I say, we ain't no pros, far from it. Just good old country boys, we're trying to catch a fish in it, but we try to figure it out and we try to work on it. We try to work on our craft and get better if we can. I think we're close, but I don't think we've hit the nail on the head yet. Could be. With our bait and stuff, just it ain't right. We ain't in the right spot. Could be the hot weather. Barometric pressure's fairly low tonight. Typical fishing pressure. But it could be that I'm just off a little bit on a little of something, and I'll just have to figure it out. Old carp choir. But I'm going to have to run and put this in the truck. We about 3 minute mark and get it charged up here. And we'll talk actions later. Hopefully we can get another one on the bank here. Worthy enough of taking another side pot or at least a spot. It's Jimbo, Possum Country Boys Outdoors. All right, Jimbo and Possum, Team Country Boys Outdoors. Got about 35% on our phone, enough to maybe here do a quick video in. While we was in the truck charging, old Possum stuck a 14.6 off his far left one here on that hook bait. And then about 10 minutes later, this one lit out of here with a 17.4. So we've had a good 30 minutes from 9:30 to 10 o'clock. It's right now about a minute after 10. We got about right at an hour to fish in. And we're going to try to catch a nudding. That's what you do. You just keep a fishing. Mm-hmm. Stay at it. But we wanted to come at you right quick and holler at you, see if we can get something to happen while we on camera. I tell you, old Carp, he quire. All the videos we've done at the fishing lake, and I think, what we caught, possum, two running with it?
Three, maybe.
Three times we've been able to catch a run on camera. Now, this one that went off while we was baiting the pops or showing how to bait the hook, that's kind of hard to count that on account of didn't get to really see it. And we got excited, and old possum got excited, and the camera was all over the place. So I tell you, they quire. Old Carp, he don't like to be on the camera, I reckon. But we didn't even get to get a picture of them that 14.6 and the 17.4 on the counter. Like I say, our camera was in the truck charging for us. But this one right here, that just went, that was one of the weirdest runs I've ever had in my life. Now, I got that and lobbed in close. He pulled it. And he hit the clickers about two times, and then he went to swimming yonder way. I just seen my line just to swimming. So I kind of give him the old bass treatment, like he picked up a lizard or a worm and started swimming with it. I just picked the rod up and kind of give him that good bass jerk. And listen, he knowed right quick he was hooked. He was mad the whole time. Now, I'm telling you, he didn't like them hooks being any none. He didn't like them Gamakatsu's in him, did he, possum?
Nah, he was going crazy. He was swimming all up and down.
Yeah,
them
he
boards.
Was just pulling back and forth yonder just to acting a fool. But we got him in, got him to the scales, and that won that 30 minutes. It's always good when you knock yourself off, ain't it, possum?
Yeah.
When you put one on the board. Now, we put one on the board. Possum put that 14.6 on the board. He didn't no more get back to the scale, get back to our fishing hole yonder, and a feller across the lake I put a 15 something on, and then we put the 17 on. So that was a good battle, good friendly competition back and forth. Them fellers over yonder where that white truck's at.
Mm-hmm.
So we went back and forth them 30 minutes with them three teenagers, and but we proud of it, and we gonna fish this last hour, and I'm gonna cut us off here. I can see they ain't wanting to do nothing for us. We'll cut it off and see if we can get a pull and save some battery. See if we can catch the fight in progress or maybe even get a run in progress, and then we'll come and close it out to you. Country Boys Outdoors. Stay tuned. What's up, everybody? It's Jimbo.
Possum.
Team Country Boys Outdoors. We didn't get to film nothing extra. Yonder, that last little bit, we'll go ahead and summarize the night for you. And, well, we got knocked off the $5 pot, but 19-1 was caught. But so we took the $3 pot, the $2 pot, two spots with a 18-2 and a 17-4. Here's why we couldn't film. We actually caught two or three more fish.
Little
it was just little. About a 2-foot copperhead comes crawling up down below us. Had one of our fishing partners pretty scared, and it wouldn't move, and he's scared he's gonna get bit on account of it. Was probably about 2 foot, and they aggressive, but we got permission from the lake owner, and I am a concealed carry holder. I do carry concealed, have my permit, and got permission from the lake owner, and went and eliminated the copperhead with the 40 caliber Glock. Went ahead and took care of him. So a lot of adrenaline running, and you know, trying to fish, and adrenaline's going through you, and I felt like I couldn't miss. If I miss, he may come after me or somebody, you know. But all that aside, good night fishing. First time we got to get back on the lake in a couple weeks.
Mm-hmm.
We go take the second and third place spot, win two spots. Old Possum caught him a couple good ones. I caught a couple good ones. Slow bite, it was hot. But you gotta fish conditions, like I always tell you. So remember, when I say leave it better than you found it, if you find trash, pick it up. If it even ain't yourn, that does include copperheads.
Yeah.
If you can do it safely,
eliminate him. If you can't do it safely, leave him be. But if you can do it safely and you can do it effectively, you didn't find that copperhead when you got there, and he comes up, get rid of him. Hey, we want to thank all of y'all. Appreciate all the subscribers. Hit that thumbs up button if you like our video. We'll try to get back at it another day this weekend, and we hope to do a catfishing trip. So we're going to spend something a little different. But thank you to everybody. God bless you. Tight lines and wet nets. Tell them, Possum.
Make sure to catch big fish when you go carp fishing. If you're going carp fishing and you ain't catching big fish, why even go?
Because we like to catch fish. Because we didn't catch all big fish.
Yeah, we did.
This is Old Possum. This is Jimbo. And this is Team Country Boys Outdoors signing off. Have a good evening. God bless you.